and then continue in its motion. So I'm going to show you the video analysis that was done by the student. Okay, so it's very nicely done. As you can see that the red dots represent the motion of the part of the tennis ball. So now I'm going to demonstrate how the learning can be made more powerful by using this thing called the video modeling by open source physics tracker. So I actually have a pre-made kinematics model, but I will not show it at the moment. I will just show you what I have done as several breakups of the actual motion. I have broken it up into free fall. So this is the free fall part. And then eventually there will be a free fall up thrust followed by the up thrust and the drag inside the water. And then you notice there's a little bounce out of the water, which I call it a bounce up. So we will model the motion of the tennis ball until here. Okay, because the rest will be pretty repetitive and easily done. So what we do is you need to do a create a new kinetic model, and then recreate it over here under free fall. In this model, when you click on the model builder, it will show you what is the variables inside this model. So mass is 1 by default, we do not need to change it. X in this case will be 0, and this is actually the Y kinematics equation. So you can see from here that actually these equations are actually taken from a very simple, if the time is lesser than 0.29, then it will do these various equations expression with a T square and then a T and then followed by a standard coefficient, a T-less term, then followed by comma 0. So what it does is, if t is lesser than this, it will run the first statement, else it will run 0, the second statement, 0. So how do we propose that students become like scientists and be able to use mathematical and computational thinking? So in any of this panel, we would like the student to do an analyze. With this, it will come up with the data tool. It is possible for the student to select the region of the data that fits pretty well. So let's say it's from T0 to T0.267, and for this region of the motion is under free fall, so the student will select from a list of fit, the parabolic fit, and from here be able to do the parabolic fit with the parameters A, B, C being the coefficients of this equation and having these values. So I would like you to remember the number negative 2.137, negative 0.1967, and followed by this 0.2310. These are actually evidences that a student can use to build a model. So I'm going to progress to show you how you can use this in a model building way. So in this model, like I said here, okay, the student were to key in these values here. So you key in this number here, negative 0.2137 over here, then followed by the t square term, as because it is a quadratic equate model, then followed by negative 0.1976 for the t term, and then followed by the last term without the t, which is 0.2310, and then followed by comma 0, which because that's the if statement that requires it to do. If this is true, it will do this, else it will do 0. Okay, so this is you can key as 1 if you want. Okay, so with this, let's see what the model can do. Now let's select it to be visible, and you can see that it matches the motion pretty well. Okay, until the time where it is obviously greater than t, greater than 0 point, then you find that the ball is always at the 0 coordinate. Okay, now how does a student know that they have done a very good model? So you can actually do a comparison of the free fall, and you can do a comparison with the free fall over here as well. So this will allow you to see how well the model that you have proposed matches up with the real data. So I can see that this actually matches very well, whereas this is pretty well, but eventually it doesn't fit quite well. Okay, now through these iterative steps where the student proposed models stage by stage, the student can now propose a different, more refined model that extends the motion into the water. So they can actually do another nested if statement inside. Okay, and with this model, we can actually now just very quickly click on it and make it visible. And you can see now that when I click the play button, it actually matches the motion of the real object pretty well. Okay, that gives an indication of how robust your model is able to represent the real life motion. Okay, and you can likewise do a compare and see the various representations. Okay, now lastly, the most I have managed to build a model until it bounces over here. So so you can continue to do using the data analysis method to get the various coefficients for the curve fit, whether it be parabolic or linear. Okay, and the student can now design and propose models that matches the actual motion. So let's uncheck on the last model that it matches. So this is the model, the completed model until a certain stage where it bounces. Okay, so it doesn't. So you can see that the model actually is pretty accurate. Okay, it matches the motion of the tennis ball. Then inside the water, it experiences up thrust and drag, and then eventually it goes up. So it still matches the motion pretty well. And then eventually, when it does this little bounce, also it's being modeled, and then it enters the water again. And then that is where I did not continue the model. Now imagine if the students were to propose equations like this and being able to understand what the coefficient means. I believe there's a lot that the student can benefit from by this kind of computational and mathematical thinking afforded through the tracker modeling pedagogy.